Hi guys, welcome to this weekly vlog. If you watched last week, you'll know we finished in this exact same position and we're starting the next one in this exact same position. Just do my makeup, maybe I'll talk you through it. And so far I've just used the NARS Velvet Matte Skin Tint in Alaska, the NARS Creamy Concealer thing, Glossier Boy Brown, NARS Laguna Bronzer next. So yeah, last week's vlog, it's so weird because this is going to have a week between it when you guys are watching it, but it has like 30 seconds between me filming it. And Jim was just saying that I wasn't feeling the best last week, this last week for you guys watching it. And you know what's also weird to think that by the time I'm editing this, who knows what I'm going to be feeling like. I might be feeling worse, might be feeling better. Just, it's really weird. It's really weird when you document everything online, how long ago certain things feel when you then edit through it the following week. Anyway, I digress. I just used Glossier Cloud Paint in Puff. Now I'm using the NARS Copacabana Illuminator just to highlight. I'm so quick at doing my makeup, guys. I can honestly get ready with my makeup in about 5 minutes. I think it's quite impressive, actually. If I had a CV, might put it on it. And for my eyes, I'm just gonna use the Surabaya palette from NARS. Today is Monday. Been to the gym, which was really, really good. I think next year I might show you what I do in the gym. I think maybe you guys would enjoy that, and my personal trainer's fantastic. So I'm gonna ask her if she would mind. Because we do lots of strength stuff. Like the other people I watch on YouTube who share gym stuff, I don't, like, not like fitness bloggers, but I feel like I do something that's a bit different. It's all about strength stuff, which I really, really thoroughly enjoy as well. So I definitely would like to share that with you guys next year. I say next year because I'm not gonna go to the gym again until next year, so we can't do it this year. And the reason I'm not gonna go to the gym again is because tomorrow I'm going home for Christmas. So today is sorting things out. I've got a meeting at 12:30 with 3 people, which is lovely. I worked with them earlier in the year. Really hope that I get to work with them again next year because I really love the brand. And then I'm seeing Lynn's. As I said, I've been a bit low recently, and Lynn's is like, possibly, I couldn't imagine a more like supportive and loyal friend or just person in your life. So she knows that I'm not feeling the best. She's like, you're not being on your own today. So we're then spending the afternoon together. I've got a lot to get done, like packing, try and clean the flat a bit so that when I come back it's not feeling like a pigsty. And things like that. I'm just shoving this on my eyes any old which way, basically. Can you tell I'm not a beauty YouTuber or blogger or anything to do with beauty? So that's today's plans. And I think Lynn wants to film my outfit for a video she's doing, so I need to put on a good outfit. The pressure is on.
Just for Linda. We're on our way to the Conran shop, which she's never been, and I want to show her. Yeah, she's going to love it.
Love.
And you're going to want to spend so much money. It honestly is amazing. So we're just on our way there while filming a video and taking photos. Did the Conran shop, review it.
Oh god.
Best ever.
I've mentally spent millions, I think.
So good. So good. Moved to my chair again, only about 5 more months to wait.
I had a sit on it and I can confirm it's worth the money.
Worth the money.
Right, let's go.
We're going.
Yeah.
Can we? I don't trust your judgment. Okay, we've gone. We're going into Acne. Hello, everybody. I'm back home in the car because Mum and I, she's just about to get in the car, are on our way to Leeds to go for dinner with some of Mum's friends. Sorry about this low car lighting. Here she is. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Are you sitting in the back?
Yes.
So yeah, that's our plan for the evening. Here she is again.
Hello. Welcome to my zoo. Put your head inside my big black wild wild. I can still help you. See the snake baboon. Funky shape. Divine. lips wine, cause he can't see you.
And parcel or two have just arrived. I accidentally did some online shopping on Matches in the sale, which isn't something I've done in ages, because I fancied a nice dress for Christmas and then got some shoes. So I've got quite a few bits, but I'm going to send lots back. I thought I'd show you what it is that I ordered. Their sale's really good, by the way, if you haven't had a look. First is this dress. What brand was this again? Osman. A silk navy blue shirt dress with buttons down the front. I'll try everything on for you in a second as well. That was one dress option. That for that box. And then a big box. Shine a light. Oh, boy. Jesus. Okay. Big box. This is another dress. This one is from Isabel Morant. Is it their toile range? No, mainline. A white cream dress, and it's got like a V-neck and a thing across the top. And then final dress option was a shirt dress, which is the kind I end up wearing all the time. This is from a brand called Awake, and it is a very oversized blue shirt dress with an amazing collar. Amazing collar. Might look a bit like a nightshirt, we'll have to see. And then I ordered some shoes. So this pair from the Web A, they could either be a real hit or a real miss, because they're very different to usual. Very Christmas, but I kind of, no, possibly not. You know how like Manolo Blahniks have that really classic, slightly old lady-esque style to them, and it really works. This is what I was thinking for these, with like denim and white t-shirts. They've got a bow with diamantes on them, a satin shoe, kind of. I hope you guys know what I mean. I'm gonna try them with some like oversized jeans and stuff and see what you think. And then another pair of shoes. As I said, I'm not keeping all of this. Obviously, this was a pretty extravagant moment on my part. These are the Jesus Man. The Balenciaga thigh highs. It's all going to depend on how that heel feels on, and their velvet and patent leather. I mean, insane. And just gonna, yeah, insane.
Right, let me try everything on.
So this is the sort of vibe I'd go for styling these Loewe shoes. They actually look really nice on the foot and they're really comfortable, not too high. And I do kind of like how girly and just twee they are with really masculine outfits. So this is the shirt dress with the shoes and I do like the look, but I think the shirt dress is too nighty-ish. It just looks like a nightshirt, even though the cotton is like really nice in the collar and it's got these tortoiseshell buttons. It's just too, especially from the side, too much like a nightshirt, I feel. Yeah. So this is on ramp one, which just does nothing really for me. Love the shoulders. I like the neck, but overall it's just like meh, not spesh. So this is a no. And then this is the Osman one, which is my favourite. I just want it taken up. I feel like if it was, oh my God, I can't get it to the length that I want, but if it just had maybe 2 or 3 inches off it, so almost that this came to the same length as the sleeves, it would balance out so much nicer. But I really, really, really like this. The sleeves are incredible. I love the white buttons. I love the fact that you could wear it buttoned up to the top like this as well. Especially if it was short, it would have like a really different vibe. But also wear it really loose and undone. I think it's going to be quite wearable. So I'm into this. Just want to get it taken up, I think. And then the Balenciaga boots, which are just insane. Like, they are so thigh high. It's ridiculous. And the heel are really hard to get on and off because it's like an actual court shoe at the bottom. And then the velvet coming up from them. They're definitely like a mega statement piece. I really do like them. But what do we think? Not gonna wear them tons, are you? Let's be honest. Me in Tesco's buying mince pies like this. Mm-mm.
So I decided to keep the Balenciaga boots and the Osman navy dress, which has just been dropped off at the tailor's to be made shorter. The rest is going back. We've just had dinner and we're just about to have a mince pie. Now, we have had one of these mince pies already today, but didn't film it, so this is our excuse to have a second one. But we do know what we think of them already. And let me tell you, a positive review is about to happen. These are the Co-op all butter mince pies. Don't like how much red is down there in the typical volume section, but these are pretty spectacular, really, aren't they?
It was nice.
So to compare it to the Dalesford, which I'm sorry I forgot to bring some back, the Dalesford tastes posher.
Okay, what does posh taste?
What does posh taste like now? I don't know how to describe it other than saying it just tastes posher.
We've also got the option, which we can do tomorrow.
Yeah.
Of creating our own.
Why? What have you got?
Little crochet more in here. Oh,
you've got mincemeat. Work.
No, you get little cases and you get mincemeat and you make your own. Somewhere in there.
Endless options.
Endless options.
But yeah, no, these are really. These might be my favourites yet, you know.
Really? Oh, well done, Co-op.
Yeah, they are pretty good. Heated with some Cointreau cream.
Well, that's very exciting. That kids do not overheat them though, is it?
They
burst and they
explode. Yeah, see, I don't have a microwave at home, so I just have to pop them in the oven.
Oh, that probably doesn't matter, really.
Yeah, no, it does because it. Yeah, it does. Ooh. Oh, the Cointreau cream changes everything.
I haven't got any more of these ones, but why not?
Any more of which ones?
The old box of
the
booths ones are very nice.
We did booths last. Oh, you got booths
no,
there?
No, not the flat ones. These are a different one.
Oh, this is so good, this one. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Good morning, guys. We are going to the spa. Mum, what's the name of the spa we're going to again?
Coniston Hall.
And I'm excited because I get to drive because Mum's insured me on her car and I miss driving loads. So, well, I'm also excited because I'm going to a spa. I'm not just about driving. Here she comes. What jacket have you gone with?
Oh, that one's, I like that one.
Got my hair made.
Peace.
Come on,
come out with Laura. We're in takeaway, we're having a takeaway break. We're gonna get back on it for a dance to burn off the chips. Yeah. Like my thinking, cheesy chips and garlic coming our way. Laura bought this coat from Urban Outfitters today and I want it, so she's probably gonna go home cold. Good morning guys, from the car again. Last night went rapidly downhill because I did my knee in again. Yay! Woo, that hurt. Landed on the other one again, which is now the most painful one because it's so flipping bruised. I've fallen on it again. So that was a laugh. Cried a lot. Went well. Today is a new day and I'm really annoyed because I really want to go on a walk today and now I can't because unless I go on a limp, which is not a good idea. Mum's just nipped into some, I actually don't, you know, I've not listened to what she said. She nipped into a cafe to get something for Christmas. Oh, she's got cakes, someone's made cakes for her. Why has she made them? I don't know what's going on. Anyway, she's doing that. Oh, then we're going to Ilkley to pick up the dress that I had shortened at the tailor's. And then later on I'm getting my hair cut. Thank God, no more of this stupid flipping fringe, which I've been cutting myself for the past few weeks. And before I leave to shoot stuff in a rush, I'm like, nah, this isn't gonna photograph well. Just take the scissors to it. So I'm going to my old hairdresser, who's like the best hairdresser I've ever had in Leeds, and he's definitely going to be like, you've taken to this with some scissors, haven't you? But I can't wait. I'm going to get it shorter and like still curtainy but shorter, and then, and I am trying to grow my hair at the moment, but I'm just believing it, whatever. So that is today's plan. Hopefully I'll vlog a bit more, hopefully I won't fall over again, hopefully I'll cheer up a little bit at some point in the near future. We live in hope. Vlogging from Waitrose car park instead of in the car now to keep me toes. Just had my hair done, gone for Jane Birkin vibes, loving it. The place to get my hair done in Leeds, which is like my favourite place to get my hair done ever, is called Full Park Square and David Cuts and Grenville Colours. I'll leave that information in the description box if you're Leeds based. Literally the best hairdresser you could ever go to. So I'm so, so pleased with it. And oh, here she is. Here she is. I'm just going to limp my way around Waitrose. I know, poor me. Poor me. Can we get some fruit? Yes. Come on, this one, this one. Come on, come on. Say bye to you. She's going inside to eat a pork pie. I'm on my way out to the garden centre to meet Emma. How elderly have we become? That's where we're going for some lunch, the garden centre. Limping like it's nobody's business. Got my knee in a bandage. Killing me. And I just put something on Instagram stories actually, which I want to say in here as well, which was a huge thank you for all the comments on last week's vlog about how we're all feeling about Christmas. It was that amazing to read through them all. And I haven't managed to reply to them all because there was a lot, but I was just like overwhelmed by it basically in a really, really good way. So I'll pop you there for a sec while we get going. So yeah, I just wanted to say a massive thank you for that because no, there's nothing makes me happier than when the comments section help other people as well. So it's like there's two parts of the content I'm creating, what I'm putting out there, and then the way that you guys respond and engage with it then brings another layer into it in terms of what people can see online through my platforms. It's more than what I'm creating, which is something I really like. So yeah, thank you so, so, so much. It's Christmas Eve today. Whoa. It's Christmas Eve today. And still not feeling Christmassy, not about to start feeling Christmassy anytime soon. So we're just cracking on with it. I better put in where the heck I'm going into the, I do know where it is, I think. Woodbank Nursery, honestly. How old are we, Emma? What else can I tell you? That's all about all I can tell you at the moment. Nurseries, Bingley. Bingley, yeah. Not too much else to report. Enter postcode. Jesus Christ! Just in the garden centre with Emma, some massive thing just set off. We had a jacket potato for lunch, Emma had some fish and chips. And it's like got loads of really nice homeware everywhere. So we're having a mooch around for some last minute Christmas gifts. Lots of really cute bits and bobs, which is really, really nice. Go wild, could go wild. Hello everybody, it's Christmas Eve. My face is a different colour to my neck. Doesn't look like it is in a mirror though, just on here. What an unfortunate situation to find myself in. I've got cousins coming around today and I've been tasked with the very important task, I was playing some Christmas music, of putting brie and chutney inside these. So that is what I shall do before I get in trouble. Oh yeah, leave this one on. Setup everywhere. Lounge. Everything's covered with cling film so that I can't get my filthy mitts on it before whoever else gets here and eat it all. Dining room, the main event. We're having a buffet thing. It's all looking very lovely. Jeez, wept it's cold in here. Hi guys, it's actually the next day now. I forgot to sign off the vlog yesterday, so it is in fact Christmas Day today. But yeah, I wanted to say thank you so much for watching. Can't even remember what I've done in this vlog. It's probably not going to be the most interesting one. But yeah, I hope you've enjoyed it all the same. On like the back of what we talked about in last week's vlog, I wanted to vlog through Christmas anyway. And yeah. It's been nice to be at home and everything like that. It's been very lovely. So thank you so much for watching. I'm gonna be back with like videos on Sunday really soon. The first week of January I'll get back going with everything. I'm just definitely gonna take a little bit of time off for maybe the next probably under a week, I think I'll start working again. But yeah, thank you so much for watching and I'll see you in the next one.